The hunt for the wedding hairstyle that will stay all day and show off the back of your dress is over with the Goddess Updo. Our wedding wingman calls this look the perfect combination of timeless and sexy, and promises with her step-by-step tutorial, you too can master this look. Without hairspray overload, her professional technique can prevent your updo from becoming a downdo. Getting you ready for your day your way is Teresa of the Bridal Goddess.
Hi everyone, thank you Vanessa for the introduction. I'm Teresa Bullock, the owner of the Bridal Goddess. I'll be showing you an updo today, and this is a style for someone who wants the hair up and off their shoulders and off of their face, a very like formal and elegant look. I'm gonna start with a really nice working medium hold hairspray, and not being too precious about it, just getting the hair with a nice amount on either side of a larger section. So the next product that I'm gonna use is a texture powder. It's called Push from Surface. For this specific style, I'm gonna start with my first section in the front. It's a little horseshoe shape right at the top of her forehead. So if we look at her from the front, I just kind of want it to be basically from like the tops of her eyebrows. And I'm gonna section that off, just out of the way. And my next section is gonna be super simple, just kind of taking it from the top of the horseshoe to the ear on both sides. So we've got our top and our two sides. We're gonna take this whole big section and go about a quarter of the way through, and just gonna cut that right in half. The part doesn't have to be super straight or specific. It's mainly just getting the section of hair that we're gonna be working with. So if Charlene had bangs and she wanted an updo, we would just structure the front a little bit differently. Instead of having this section right on the front of her forehead here, we would work with if she had full bangs or if she had half side bangs, maybe have a different part. And it definitely can work with any type of bang. You just structure the front a little bit different. So maybe you would take this section just behind the bangs and just move it back just a little bit. So now that we've got it all sectioned out and we have a plan, we're gonna add some curl and some texture, and it's gonna help give us a lot of really beautiful volume and texture for this romantic, elegant updo. So first I'm gonna start off with using a medium tapered wand and just gonna go through these three front sections. And I'm focusing on close to the scalp and the mid-length. Not so much the ends. She already has a little bit of bend, which is gonna work perfect for the updo. But what I wanna do right now is just twist this around so that we get texture and curl right at that mid part of the strand of hair. And I'm gonna go through and do this through this all three sections. I'm gonna go through and just take each section that I already curled and give it a little back comb. So basically I'm gonna hold it straight up, put the comb in, and push it down just a few times to give it a little of that kind of tangliness. You can kind of already tell right now it makes it stand up kind of wild. Go through and just do each little section like that. She likes a lot of volume around the top of her head and her face, so I'm not gonna be too precious about it. I'm gonna get some good volume in there. And then once I get this done on this side, I will show you how we're gonna move into the back here and do some really fun techniques so that it will give us a really super easy, really pretty texture for the updo. Okay, so I've got my three sections. They don't necessarily need to be in three sections anymore. Just keep them out of the way because we're working on this middle section that we set aside. Just gonna give it a little smoothing and a little comb. And I'm gonna split this into half, clip aside this right one, and I'm gonna be working with just this left section right here. And then we're gonna split it one more time. So next we're gonna use a hair elastic and just put a little low pony in there. And I'm gonna scooch it down just a little bit. You want a little bit of room. I guess it's maybe a few inches from her scalp. And then, so if any of you remember the Topsy Tail, it's back, we're doing it again. I'm gonna stick my finger basically like I was parting it in the middle. And I'm gonna keep that elastic right there. Try not to let it scooch down at all. So it's down the middle. Got your two sections, and you're just gonna flip that right in between like that. So then it creates these really pretty little twists. And from here, take some little pieces of hair from the outside and just give a little tug, kind of fluff it up a little bit. And since I know she likes volume, I'm gonna pull a little bit more up here. Great. I'm gonna give a little spray and move on to my second section. We're gonna do the same thing over. Get my hair elastic, put it in the same spot, wrap it around twice, and just kind of visually look about where I had that. It looks about right. But my finger, split that right down in the middle, open that up, and I kind of spread it open so it's a little easier for you to see. And then just push that right through like so. And again, just gonna pull some little pieces from the outside to kind of fluff, add some nice texture, volume. As we're working a little bit, I'm gonna talk about having really healthy, beautiful hair for your wedding day. I get that question a lot. One, because brides are always wanting to look their best, and it's an important piece of it. So I think getting trims every 6 to 8 weeks is just gonna help keep the ends looking really nice. You know, you'd only have to do like a little half inch, just keep it really nice and clean. And then talk to your hair care professional about a hair mask. Like, do a hair mask maybe once a week, a few months before the wedding, and that's just gonna keep it really lustrous, really shiny, and really healthy so that you can have your best palette of hair to work with. So now that I have my two little topsy tails, I'm just gonna join them both together with another hairband. And this is gonna be covered up with more hair in the end, so I'm not gonna be too concerned about it. When you have these little topsy tails and stuff, it's really fun to just work with that texture that it creates and play around with it. And then next I'm gonna work with this section, and then lastly we'll work with the front. I'm just gonna pin this up and out of the way, just real lightly so that we don't mess anything up too much, and then split this in half. Again, doesn't need to be perfect. Just gonna section this out of the way and work on this left section. Just gonna comb this a little bit because we're gonna do some braids. And so it's just a traditional 3-strand braid. Gonna put 2 fingers in to section out and make them all equal in size. And just gonna do a traditional 3-strand braid. And I'm doing it really loose, because we're not actually doing this to see the braid, we're doing it more for just some texture and some loops. And since she does have thicker hair, it's a really nice way to get some structure. And then I'm gonna do a little tug, a little pull on each of them, just fluff them out a little bit. You can even kind of smoosh it with your finger. And then I'm not gonna put a hair elastic on it because I wanna be able to work with it in the style. So I'm actually just gonna do a little back comb, just enough to hold it for now. It doesn't need to hold forever. Give it a little hairspray, and then moving on to our other second section. All right, so we've got our front section, our middle section, and now this third section. So this tail here, I'm gonna give it a little twist and kind of do a bun. Doesn't need to be super perfect. And just pin that in. So you can see I've got a nice little kind of bun formation starting, and I'm gonna wrap these around just to create a really pretty low bun. If you didn't have as much hair as Charlene, you could put a, what's called a hair donut instead of this little bun. You can put that in there and you would never see it. Maybe you've seen those, you know, in stores where you can buy like little hair socks or hair donuts. That's a really great way to do it. Hair extensions is another really great idea. But there's a lot of different ways to give the look of having a lot of lustrous hair without actually having that much hair. So I'm just gonna kind of get my eyes on here real level, and I actually really like some of these little short pieces that are coming out. I think it looks really pretty. I'll go through and give them a little bit more bend with the curling iron later. And just noticing where I can give support with bobby pins. And I'm just gonna give enough support with bobby pins right now so that I can see where the style is. And at the end, once I know I really love it, then I'm gonna really lock it in with bobby pins. Isn't this looking really beautiful? So we have this really beautiful texture here. I, you know, just put a little bit of a pin to kind of gather that together. You wouldn't necessarily know that those are braids. It just looks really pretty and textured. And we're gonna work into these front sections now. And I don't wanna cover everything up, but I want to just kind of put everything together and work with some of this texture under here. And just place everything into what we've already started with the hair bun. I'm gonna keep a lot of this texture in, so I'm gonna keep, you know, like doing little twists and stuff so that I don't lose all this beautiful curl that I made with wand. And just visually going through and doing what you need to do so that you don't see any of the parts, you know, keep it really pretty. Maybe pull out a little piece just to keep it really soft and pretty around the hairline. So this middle section on the top here is what's gonna hide this part line here. I'm gonna work with my comb as I go just to smooth any little flyaways. She has some really beautiful highlights in here, so it really helps add some nice dimension. You know, brides ask me about color a lot too. If you're somebody who colors your hair, it can look really pretty to have an updo. You have some sort of dimension in your hair, some sort of highlights like Charlene here. She doesn't have a lot of highlights, but she has some around the face, which as you can tell, just gives it a really pretty contrast. So I've got all of these front pieces in this hairline section pinned back. I've got them kind of going down the center to cover up that part, and then just kind of putting them wherever it looks pretty, honestly. So I grouped together a few of those little pieces and just loop these around however your heart desires. And then I'm just gonna do a little bit of pinning as needed. And then we're gonna move into finishing this all off so that it holds all day and all night long, and what products to use. All right, so I've got this all pinned in, and there's just a little bit of detailing that I wanna do. So I'm gonna use the tail part of this comb. So this is just the part that you wanna get real picky, you know, look at everything really closely. So just double checking her little pieces in the front I really like. I'm gonna give these little back pieces just a little bend, and I'm gonna use my finishing spray. So it's called finishing spray for a reason. When you have things the way you want it, you're gonna finish off with it because it's a stronger hold hairspray. And then very lastly is my favorite, a shine spray. Don't have to go too crazy with this. A few little sprays here and there just give it a little extra sheen. Looks really pretty in pictures, and when the light hits it, it just gives it a really lustrous look, really healthy and beautiful. So there you have it, a very romantic, classic updo, fit for any goddess. I hope you enjoyed the elegant updo. Check the description below for more about me, and don't forget to click the like button. Share with anyone who would find this useful, and subscribe to Wed Mayhem for more advice from myself and other industry insiders. Again, I'm Teresa Bullock of The Bridal Goddess with Wed Mayhem, and we are vowed to your vision.